Corruption and redemption is at the heart of the new expansion. We've seen the living flame turn to pure holy light, and a wild elite gnoll chieftain turn to the scourge and horror of the forest. We've even got a new Deathwing. What if Ysera, the aspect of nature, like in the lore, was to turn dark, evil and twisted, corrupted by the Emerald Nightmare? Well, let's have a look. Ysera is a legendary that gradually builds card advantage, gaining minions and powerful dream cards the longer you have her on the board, the stronger she is and the more value you get out of her. What could an evil, corrupted Ysera bring to the table? Well, she's still 9 mana, 4/12. At the end of your turn though, add a corrupted dream card to your opponent's hand. Essentially the opposite of Ysera, she now gives your opponent cards instead of yourself, gradually filling the hand with nightmares.
How would you like to sleep? Forever!
So, what are these corrupted dream cards? They better be bad, right? Essentially, they work somewhat like Curse of Rifan, in forcing your opponent to either waste mana to get rid of them, if not, they have some form of negative effect whilst in hand. First off, we have Satyr Corruption. 4 mana, whenever you play a minion, if this is in your hand, summon a 4/4 Satyr for your opponent. Aggro type decks with mostly small minions shouldn't have that much trouble, spells and weapons can bypass it too. But it's a huge pain if you want to play big minions like say Ragnaros, Nefarian or even Dr. Boom without giving a free Satyr.
Get in there and fight, maggot!
This one's the reverse, it's Midnight Horror, 4 mana whenever you cast another spell. If this is in your hand, add a random spell to your opponent's hand. Like having a Lorewalker Cho annoyingly affecting your hand only. Over time, it can gradually generate a whole hand. Big spells like Pyroblast, Mind Control of course, there's no way around giving your opponent a free spell. Next up, Nightmare Drake, 3 mana, 0/5, your spells cost 2 more. If this is in your hand, your other minions cost 2 more instead. This one's particularly annoying, it's a lose-lose situation. But once down, your opponent does at least get a 0/5 body. What's great about it is it combos with all your other corrupted dream cards. Satyr Corruption, for example, would now cost 6 mana, making them all even harder to get rid of. Onto a really nasty one, it's Reoccurring Nightmare, 5 mana, 0/1. At the end of your turn, if this is in your hand, add a random corrupted dream card to your hand. It can get out of control fairly quickly if left unchecked. You can essentially give your opponent 2 corrupted dream cards by the end of his turn. Double the trouble. It gives no negative effects though for your opponent, he can just ignore it and play for a win condition. Last one, it's Essence Leech, 5 mana, at the end of your turn, if this is in your hand, transfer 2 health to the enemy hero. Slowly withers your opponent's health, stealing it like a vampire. No way of getting out of this one, drain life every turn, all your opponent has to spend to get rid of it. Alright, so which Ysera would you run in your deck? Normal, or would the corruption tempt you to the dark side? What other corrupted or redeemed legendaries would you like to see? We could do a redeemed Juraxxus. What if Eridor Lord chose a different path like Velen? Should he still replace your hero, new weapon and hero power too? Or how about an alternate Dr. Boom? Instead of mechanical, he ran wild with the beast. Battlecry summoned 2 huffers. No, just joking. How would you have him? What about a dark corrupted Tyrion wielding the corrupted Ashbringer? What would a Dark Paladin Champion of the Old Gods abilities be? Follow me on Facebook and Twitter to see updates and subscribe for more legendaries.
I am the essence of magic!
Next up, the Lifebinder, Guardian of All.